Hey, Master Gardeners. Here I am, a homeowner that's having trouble with a ground cover. And if you've got this in your yard, we call it Bishop's Weed is one of the names, also called Goutweed, Aegopodium, podagraria, problematic weed. Typically, when people are really planting it in their yard, it's coming in the variegated form, which is relatively pretty, and it was introduced into the United States as a ornamental for this wonderful variegated. One of the nicknames is Snow on the Mountain, which you can see how beautiful it is. But now it is considered so aggressive that in Maryland, it's on a watch list. Watch list means that it's not against the law to sell it in the state of Maryland, but it's on the list to eventually be raised up to being regulated so that the garden centers would be required to put a sign on it saying this species is invasive in Maryland. But what's it look like? It's about anywhere from 14, 18 inches tall, has leaves. Here's a traditional leaf on it. This one is not as big as you might imagine. But there's your typical lots of leaflets, typically almost 9 leaflets. And the shape of this is named for the bishop's mitre. That's why it's called Bishop's Weed. So the little hats that are sometimes worn by a Catholic priest. So that's why it's so named. But there it is in the green. Now what happens? You buy the variegated, it reverts to the motherly color and it becomes much, much more aggressive. It's a really effective ground cover for the shade. And that's why it's been grown so much. Very versatile, all different types of soil. And look at the flower. It's June in Maryland right now. Here's your typical flower. And he went anywhere from 3 inches to up to 5 inches. Looks like a parsley, doesn't it? Looks like a carrot. That's because it's in that same family, Apiaceae family. So very flexible, but problematic because when it gets established in our woodlands, it's taking out space where our spring ephemerals cannot compete with it. And that's the problem, is it's so aggressive. So this is truly a garden thug that you want to control. How do you control it? That's what this homeowner's asking, because it's up in her azaleas. So you can spend 20 years just hand pulling it, trying to get it down. Look at it coming up in the back of the azaleas back here. It's almost 3 feet, 2.5 feet tall in the back here. So definitely a problem. One thing could be that if she wanted to dig her azaleas out of here and move them out and then keep mowing this, which I doubt that that would even stop it, but maybe solarizing, laying plastic on it to stop it. Whatever you do, you don't dig it, because every little piece of root that is left in the soil, here's what the little roots look like. And oop, that little piece fell off. Every little half inch little section is going to start another new plant. So it comes all through the soil. Here's a piece down in the soil. Every little fragment, all you do is stimulate it when you try to till it or cut it up. So whatever you do, don't try that action. And then as a last option would have to be a chemical warfare on your part, possibly a glyphosate spray in the fall months. But truly a thug throughout Maine. Finding that it creates some problems with the soil chemistry. So a lot of problems with this. Don't plant Bishop's Weed in your yard. There you go, Maryland invasive.